I never met a monster I didn't like.
This is the life and times of
people. All the powers manifested in the people.
And said, you're the princess.
Chefs kind of dig the book.
Live from New York, it's... Well, you know the rest.
Only put your lid in my mustache, remind for...
Hello.
I'm Vincent Price. And you're invited to my party in the house on Haunted Hill, where so far the ghosts have murdered only 7 people. So won't you come and make it 8?
Vincent Price was known as the godfather of horror in the macabre. With over 5 decades in the industry, spanning from the early days of cinema right into the beginning of the 1990s, generations of fans grew to love and expect amazing, grandiose performances from Price. However, even beloved, famous actors often come from humble or not-so-humble beginnings. Born in 1911 in St. Louis, Missouri, to Vincent Price Sr. and Marguerite Cobb, Vincent Jr. was born into intelligence and drive. Price Sr. was the co-founder of the National Candy Company, a local civic leader, and an influential figure in the confectionery industry in the early 1900s. Vincent Price's grandfather, a self-made millionaire in his own right, patented cream of tartar, the baking powder substance used in baking many types of cookies, cakes, and biscuits. Grandfather Price also founded the Dr. Price Baking Powder Company in 1869. Being born into an affluent family allowed Vincent Price the finest education available, as well as traveling often around the country and globe, a childhood he's often said started his love of arts and cultures. Graduating from Yale in 1933, Price initially worked as a schoolteacher, a profession he later said gave him the extraordinary experience of finding out he knew nothing. After realizing the life of an educator wasn't for him, he would move to London and attend the University of London for a Master's of Fine Arts degree. This would only further his love of arts and theater. There was only one issue that stood in his way, the height at which he stood. Price was not a short fellow, standing at 6'1" tall, with a thin, graceful frame, it was often difficult for him to find roles that allowed for such an imposing figure. His first onstage appearance comes from a London rendition of Chicago, which led to his first lead in the production of Victoria Regina in 1935. Due to the production's popularity, the play would travel to Broadway and bring Price along with it. Starring alongside Helen Hayes, Price played the role of Prince Albert so long he joked that he came along with the sets. While Price continued to act in stage productions, he would eventually begin auditioning for roles in cinema. He would make his film debut in the 1938 comedy Service Deluxe as the character Robert Wade. Continuing to act in stage plays and as supporting characters on film, Vincent would continue to hone his craft of mesmerizing audiences.
I'm his daughter. How do you do?
How do you do?
Wouldn't you like to wait upstairs in my sitting room? If you like music, I have a wonderful collection of Beethoven records.
If you don't mind, I think I'll wait here. They told me I had just exactly 17 and a half minutes. At that rate, I figure I've got about 38 seconds to go.
It wasn't until 1953's original House of Wax that fans would truly see his mastery at play. Starring in the lead role as the museum's curator, Professor Henry Girard, it was his soft but dark tone and intimidating figure that truly made the character feel menacing and uneasy. The acting skills of Price allowed the character to feel tangible, almost as if he would reach through the screen at any moment and make you the next exhibit in his hall of ghastly horrors. House of Wax was the highest-grossing horror film of that year and the 4th highest-grossing film overall, and would go on to inspire future generations of filmmakers and fans alike.
You shouldn't have done that, my dear.
It is Kathy. It's Kathy's body under the wax. I knew it. I knew it all the time.
As we all know, life and people within society are rarely black and white. Early 1950s America was a breeding ground for nationalistic rhetoric. Led by Senator Joseph McCarthy, the radical accuser would lead a witch hunt across America. Anyone the senator didn't like became known as an enemy to the state or un-American. These witch hunts often targeted the film industry, news media, and journalists. It was during this time that pro-Nazi letters written by a young Price would come to light. His views quickly changed as the war began, however, and Hitler's ideals would become apparent. Recognizing the damage and terror being brought on, he began aggressively advocating for civil and human rights. These old views and his friendships with poet Dorothy Parker and playwright-cum-activist Lillian Hellman landed him squarely in the ire of Senator McCarthy. This scrutiny would go on to jeopardize his career, causing him to sign the Loyalty Oath, a document provided by the FBI, which stated the actor disavowed any communist or socialist ideas, declaring himself loyal to America and its government. Many actors, directors, journalists, college professors, and others would sign similar oaths, largely due to social stigma and fear of losing their careers or homes at the time. As McCarthy's shadow began to fade over America, things became less rocky as Price would go on to star in the 1958 film The Fly, which many don't realize is the original to the 1986 cult film starring Jeff Goldblum. Then, the 1959 film House on Haunted Hill, another horror classic which was remade in the early 2000s. Also, in 1959, he would star in The Tingler. Famously, at the film's initial debut, certain seats in cinemas were rigged to vibrate at key moments during the film, making this the first ever 4D movie. For those unfamiliar with theater mechanics, a 4D film is a film with in-person elements. The original 1975 debut of Rocky Horror Picture Show is the most well-known example, having cinema workers dress up as characters from the film and acting out or involving audience participation in some ways.
I'm William Castle, and I feel obligated to warn you about the next attraction you will see at this theater. The picture is The Tingler, which I directed, and for the first time in motion picture history, members of the audience, including you, will actually play a part in the picture. You will feel some of the physical reactions, the shocking sensations experienced by the actors on the screen.
We interrupt your regularly scheduled programming to bring you this public service announcement from the crew at Milliways. Quote, help us in our struggle against the algorithm overlords by liking this transmission and subscribing to keep up to date on future activity, end quote. Don't panic, join us today!
Although he would continue to appear in a range of projects, it was always the darkly polite yet menacing villains he played that would attract and enthrall audiences. An avid fan of classic literature, especially Gothic writer Edgar Allan Poe, Price would star in film renditions of House of Usher, The Pit and the Pendulum, and Mask of the Red Death. Side note, for those in the US who grew up in the 90s and early 2000s, one of these film renditions is likely the first time you'd seen Vincent Price. These films were, and may still be, used widely by every English teacher in an attempt to get teens and preteens to appreciate classic literature.
Where is she? You buried your own sister alive!
I did. But she's dead now.
The master hand of the macabre creates its masterpiece.
While Price continued to lend his talents to the silver screen, he was equally prolific on the small screen. Starring or guest starring in numerous TV programs, he was a frequent guest on The Muppet Show, The Carol Burnett Show, The Red Skelton Hour, The Brady Bunch, the 1960s Batman series, and starred in The 13 Ghosts of Scooby-Doo in 1985. It ran for 13 episodes and ended without Scooby and the gang catching the 13th ghost. Growing up, I was a huge fan of the show, although among Scooby diehards, it's largely panned. It's a stellar voice performance from an actor that was in his mid-70s at the time.
Let's get him, Bogle!
I'm a witch, you weird!
Only you can return the demons to the chest.
Glorious!
Because you let them out. The 13 Ghosts of Scooby-Doo.
He would also lend his iconic voice and laugh to the song Thriller by Michael Jackson. Along with working with musicians, he was also known for being close friends with fellow horror icon Peter Cushing, rock star Alice Cooper, and the mistress of Macabre, Elvira.
For no mere mortal can resist the evil of the Thriller. Can you dig it?
His appreciation of life, culture, and the arts didn't stop at film and stage, however. Being an avid art collector, Price felt that fine art should be accessible by all walks of life, instead of being relegated for those with the means and privilege to enjoy them. During the 1950s, he worked under the Indian Arts and Crafts Board to support indigenous culture and served as an art consultant for Sears Roebuck for nearly a decade. During his time with Sears, they offered the Vincent Price Fine Art Collection, which would go on to sell upwards of 50,000 high-quality art prints to the public. These prints included works by such greats as Dali, Picasso, and Rembrandt. Public access to the arts was extremely important to Price, and he saw his deal with Sears as a way to put his populist views into practice. In the mid-1980s, Price would receive devastating news. He had been diagnosed with lung cancer. Doctors at the time began all possible treatment options, and through all of this, Price continued to act and appear in television programs. Filming one of his last roles as the creator for the 1990 Tim Burton film, Edward Scissorhands.
Or should the centerpiece be allowed to remain? It is so easy to commit embarrassing blunders. But etiquette tells us just what is expected of us and guards us from all humiliation and discomfort. Yes, boring. Let us switch to some poetry. There was an old man from the Cape who made himself garments of crepe. When asked, will they tear? He replied, here and there, but they keep such a beautiful shape. That's right. Go ahead, smile, it's funny. That's right.
Vincent Price would succumb to the complications from lung cancer in 1993. Throughout his life, Vincent was a kaleidoscope of skills and talents, sharing his beliefs and goals with the world and people around him. Not only did he earn the respect and admiration for his acting, but also for his outspoken support for the LGBTQ community and his numerous contributions to the fine arts community. Beyond starring in more than over 100 films, he also wrote 4 cookbooks during the 60s and 70s, including my favorite title, Cooking Pricewise with Vincent Price, and is one of only 4 actors to guest star on the live-action Batman show and The Muppet Show. Generations grew up with images of Price's iconic figure and his larger-than-life performances, but since his death in the 1990s, he has slowly begun to fade into the annals of history. Without Price's contributions to the film industry, and the horror genre specifically, we would not have the style or techniques we do today. Thank you for watching this video. If you liked what you saw, please consider liking this video and subscribing to see more content like this. Comment down below if there were any interesting facts you never knew about Vincent Price, your favorite Price role, or any possible subjects you'd like to see us cover in future installments. No matter what, we hope you have a wonderful day and a beautiful tomorrow.